China already built a dam so massive it slightly slowed Earth's rotation. It powers more than 70 million homes. And now, China is building something even bigger. A project so powerful it could reshape an entire river system, affect countries downstream, and test the limits of engineering in one of the most dangerous places on Earth. For decades, China has defined what modern mega engineering looks like. It built faster, larger, and more aggressively than any nation in history. And no project symbolized that dominance more than the Three Gorges Dam. At the time, it was the largest power station ever constructed. A concrete wall so vast it subtly altered Earth's rotation by a fraction of a microsecond and generated enough electricity to power more than 70 million homes. For years, Three Gorges stood as the ultimate expression of scale. But now, China is preparing something far bigger. A project so extreme that it makes Three Gorges look restrained, so remote that few people have seen the site, and so powerful that its consequences could ripple far beyond China's borders. Please take a moment to subscribe and like the video. It really helps the channel. The story begins high on the Tibetan Plateau, often called the roof of the world. This is where Asia's great rivers are born, fed by glaciers and snowfields at altitudes that push both humans and machines to their limits. One of those rivers is the Yarlung-Tsangpo. It flows for more than 1,000 kilometers across Tibet, carving through some of the planet's most inaccessible terrain. Then, without warning, the river makes a dramatic near 180-degree turn around the eastern edge of the Himalayas. This bend is violent, compressed, and extreme. Over just 50 kilometers, the river drops nearly 2,000 meters in elevation. After this plunge, it leaves China, becomes the Brahmaputra, and continues into India, Bangladesh, and eventually the Bay of Bengal. What happens here does not stay here. At the heart of this bend lies a gorge unlike anything else on the planet. The Great Bend Canyon is the largest on Earth, deeper and longer than the Grand Canyon by a factor of 3. For most of modern history, it was effectively unreachable. Roads only arrived in 2013, opening a region previously known more to satellites than people. In July 2025, construction officially began on a project designed specifically for this location. Engineers were drawn here for one reason above all others. This is the steepest natural hydropower drop on the planet, a place where gravity concentrates energy more densely than anywhere else on Earth. The project is known as the Lower Yarlung, or Yaxia, hydropower project. When complete, it is expected to deliver an installed capacity of 60 gigawatts. That single number changes everything. This would make it the largest single energy source ever built by humanity. Annual output is projected at 300 billion kilowatt hours, more electricity than the entire United Kingdom consumes in a year. That is nearly 3 times the output of the Three Gorges Dam. The cost reflects the ambition. At roughly 1.2 trillion yuan, or around $167 billion, it is 4 to 5 times more expensive than Three Gorges. No power project in history comes close. This scale cannot be achieved with a traditional dam wall. Instead, engineers are believed to be deploying a diversion-based system unlike anything previously attempted at this magnitude. Rather than stopping the river outright, the design likely includes an upstream regulating dam that feeds water into multiple underground tunnels. These tunnels would carry the flow through the surrounding mountains, where turbines are carved directly into the rock itself. After generating power, the water would be released downstream through a re-regulation dam to stabilize flow. The volume of water diverted could rival that of the Rhine River. China has done something similar before at the Jinping hydropower stations, but this project pushes that concept to a completely different scale. The engineering challenges are extreme. The Tibetan Plateau sits at the collision zone of 6 tectonic plates, making it one of the most seismically active regions on Earth. History offers a warning. In 1950, an earthquake here reached a magnitude of 8.6, one of the strongest ever recorded on land. Engineers must also contend with extreme altitude, oxygen-poor air, freezing temperatures, unstable slopes, and constant landslide risk. Over decades, Even reinforced concrete and steel face accelerated degradation under these conditions. This is a place where nature sets hard limits, and even China's most experienced hydropower engineers are working close to them. China's identity as an engineering state helps explain the timing. Megaprojects have long served as tools to stimulate the economy, absorb industrial capacity, and signal national confidence. Today, China faces slowing investment and weaker domestic consumption. This project immediately boosts demand for steel, cement, and heavy construction services. Markets noticed. Shares of major construction and engineering firms surged following the announcement. But the motivation goes deeper. This power is intended to fuel data centers, artificial intelligence infrastructure, and energy-intensive industries, while reducing reliance on fossil fuels at scale. China has pledged to reach net zero emissions by 2060. Officials claim the Lower Yarlung project alone could cut carbon emissions by 300 million tons per year by displacing coal-fired generation. Beyond the numbers, this is about positioning. China is signaling that climate action does not require restraint, but scale. The message is clear. If climate change is a problem of magnitude, then magnitude itself can be the solution. History suggests caution. The Three Gorges Dam displaced more than 1.3 million people and permanently altered ecosystems along the Yangtze. Advocacy groups warn similar patterns could repeat here, with communities relocated from ancestral lands and limited public consultation. Environmental impacts often unfold slowly. Concrete seepage, sediment disruption, and changes in river ecology can take decades to fully emerge. In a system this large, even small miscalculations can compound over time. Downstream nations are paying attention, and they have reason to. Along the Mekong River, China has already built 12 major dams. Studies show flood peaks downstream have been reduced by up to 20%, while dry season water levels have risen to 3 times their natural state. These changes have disrupted fisheries, destabilized agriculture, and affected the livelihoods of millions across Southeast Asia. The Mekong offers a preview of how upstream control can reshape entire regions. For India and Bangladesh, the stakes are even higher. The Brahmaputra depends heavily on sediment flowing from the Yarlung Tsangpo Gorge, with around 40% of its fertile material originating there. The core concern is not just water volume, but transparency. Border disputes already strain relations, and fears of water weaponization persist. China insists the project will not reduce downstream flows. India is not waiting to find out. Plans are already underway for a counter-project, a massive dam on the upper Siang River, just 90 kilometers from the border. This is not just an infrastructure project. It is a statement about climate leadership, energy dominance, and geopolitical leverage. If successful, the Lower Yarlung project will set a new benchmark for human engineering, proving that entire river systems and energy economies can be re-engineered at unprecedented scale. But power of this magnitude never comes without consequences. The question is no longer whether it can be built. It is whether the world can afford both the power it promises and the risks it creates. Thanks for watching Unthinkable Build. We'll see you in the next one.